Alright, now we need to get back to her. Or we need to get to her. We'd asked her to wait. That's interesting that she said she'd wait. That's interesting. I wonder if we're actually going to get to meet her. Okay, I have absolutely no idea which way to go. We need to go, north, right? North. North is this way. Here we go. Going north. Past the porta potty. Oh, I don't. Oh, there's the baseball. Goodbye, baseball. Goodbye, Forest Burns. I can't say goodbye to the baseball. Wait a minute, here we go. There.
Picture of a baseball.
Alright, if I can't take it with me, I'll take a picture of it. Oh, brother. Crap, which way? I need to go back this way, over here. And down here. Here we go. I'm coming, Delilah. I'm coming. Wait for me. I'm a coming. Coming, Delilah. Run, Henry. Run. Why'd you stop? Run, man. Run. Okay. Keep going, buddy. You got a ways to run, but you can do it. You can do it. You have no stamina bar. I know you can do it. Alright. Down here. Down here. Another helicopter or plane or something. Sounds like a helicopter, right? Okay. Down here. Down back through the cave. Alright. Through here. Alright. Let's go. Is there anything new in here? Nope. Let's go. Let's go. Let's get moving. Jump over the fence, or the log. Okay. Am I going the right way? Yeah. We'll go this way. Let's go. Let's do this. Come on, Henry. You can do it, man. You can do it. Guess we'll never really know what the real story was with that burnt cabin, huh? Guess. Oh crap, now which way do I go? Through here? Up here? Why doesn't this look familiar? Probably because it's all smoky. Okay, so the cabin was there to the right. This way, I think. Yeah, climb over this log. Remember this. Okay, through here. Through here? Lost my trail. I lost my trail. Where's my trail? Through here? Imagine if I, like, got turned around and I didn't realize it. No, I think I'm going the right way. Oh. Whoa, looks like I'm on. Well, let's see. See where this takes us. Down here? Through here? Man, I didn't realize there were so many ways to go. Over here? Climb up? Okay. A long drop down. Alright. Let's go. Crap. Interesting. This is kind of a shortcut. If we still have the equipment with us. Clear. We do. Alright. through we go. That's kind of neat. Okay. Running straight ahead. This way, maybe? Yeah, this way. Okay. I'm really curious to see if Delilah's gonna be here. See if we actually see another human being in this game. Should be interesting. I don't think she'll be there. I think she said she'd stay, but she really didn't. Alright, we're getting close. We're almost there. Up here. I believe this will take us. There's her tower. Oh, it's here waiting for us. Here it is.
Hey, I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah?
Yep. I knew it. She took off. I knew it. I freaking knew it. She didn't wait. She didn't wait for us. Whoa. Holy moly. Oh my gosh. What are we gonna see over here? Alright. Now what? Let's see. What does my map look like now? I don't have a map anymore. Oh, I guess I lost my map on the tram. Whoa. What the hell? I could go down here? Wait, what? Wait a minute. What? Wait a minute. Why is it letting me go down here? What the? What? Okay. Interesting. Alright. Well, that's kind of cool, I guess. Wow, I was wondering how far it was going to let me go. Because it seems pretty evident that we're supposed to go this way. This way up here, that is. There's the tower. It's this way. Okay. Alright, let's go up to the tower. See what's up here waiting for us. Here's her outhouse. Oh! Have a good time. What's this? What is this? Why can't I pick this up? What is this? What is that? Well, I can't interact with it. Her outhouse is a lot nicer than ours was. Well, that's strange that that little thing is there and we can't interact with it. Why? Use. There. Okay. Pretty steep hill. Whoa, wait a minute. Oh, here we go. Man, her.
God, it's a nightmare out there.
Who are you talking to?
Delilah.
Yep, she's gone. She's gone. Thanks a lot, Delilah. Thanks a lot. Damn it indeed. Picture of Teddy Roosevelt. Lucian's Gambit. Timothy Howell. Book 16 of the Chronicles of Crindle. The thrilling continuation of the best-selling series of novels that have gripped the world. When we last joined our hero, he had been separated from his allies by the evil Venom Fang, whose plot to conquer all of the mortal realms was nearing fruition. Sounds kind of like a fantasy novel, doesn't it? 1001 crosswords. It's a lot of crosswords. Can't put it back. Put back. 1001 more crosswords. That's a lot of crosswords. Forrest Burns can dig it. Desk radio. Headset. Equip. Okay, we'll put that on. Tequila. Oh, I threw it. I didn't know I could throw stuff this whole game. I didn't know that. I'm keeping it. Keep the tequila. This is one heavy backpack. Apple slice. Fireline handbook. Oh, here's the drawing of Henry. Aw. Hi, I'm Shelly. Henry, what we know? White shorts. He's getting attacked by a bear. Not sure what that's supposed to be in the upper left-hand corner. Henry, it's his sad eyes. His Raleigh Fingers mustache. His thick beard. And his tower on fire. Let's look around a little bit before we put those on. I imagine if we put those on, she's probably going to talk to us. I'm going to guess. Mug. What's her mug say? Nothing. We've got the fire danger rating. Another mug. Some delicious Biff peanut butter. Glass cleaner. Looks like a drawer with some of those granola bars in it. Yep, dish soap, thermos. Yeah, this is all great. Everything. There's her slippers. Well, here's an empty bottle of tequila down there. Can we open her desk drawer? Doesn't look. Well, maybe not. Well, let's put the headset on. She's probably going to talk to us when we put the headset on, don't you think? Where's her bookshelf? I guess that's it down there. Doesn't have any Neil Black books there. To Mule Point, Cache 302, Thunder Canyon. This is pretty something. This is pretty eroded. Something leaving through Mule Point, maybe. All right, let's, I just want to make sure I'm not missing anything, is all. All right, let's put on the headset.
Hello, is anybody there?
Hi, yeah, it's me.
You're not here.
No, don't be mad.
I'm disappointed.
I'm not mad. I'm just...
You're not mad? You're just disappointed?
I'm not your dad after you got busted smoking pot.
I just couldn't be out there for another minute.
Well, you could have just said that.
You really wanted me to stay.
I did. And now I'm...
disappointed.
Yeah.
I know. Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No, and you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
All right, sure. Maybe...
Come to Boulder with me, move to Santa Fe, become a crossword editor at the New York Times. He's still married. Yeah, Santa Fe.
Maybe move to Santa Fe. Open a jade emporium with your sister.
I'd be trading cute ski bombs for yoga retreat hippies, but maybe that's not all bad.
Plus the margarita situation.
I mean, yeah.
So what about me?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
I am. Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Mm-hmm. Would you? Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure.
Henry, I... Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
Let's see. I think you should go see her.
Right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah?
Well, you should try to take her advice, too.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
Yeah, you too.
You too. Good luck.
No. Henry, you keep it for yourself, okay? Bye, Hank.
Oh, wow, you actually see the helicopter. There it is. And I wanted to look at this first. Redneck Grebe? Magnificent Frigate Bird Osprey Wood Stork. I don't know what that is. I drew an elk there. She likes to put these little borders on the corner here. Guess we better get down to the helicopter so it doesn't take off without us. Let's go. Oh yeah, by the way, did you notice the pork pond? She took the pork pond sign. Alright, helicopter. I'm a-coming. Don't leave without me. Come on. Come on, Henry, let's go. I can't run to the helicopter, apparently. It was actually a helicopter. Wow. Am I actually going to see another human being in this game? Yeah, there's somebody there. Look. Look, a human. Go home. And here we go. Well, that was pretty cool. Certainly did not figure that one out. That is for sure. I will say that old Ned did a really good job of making it look like there were people spying on him and Delilah, on Henry and Delilah. Is this our film here? Yeah, look how many blanks there are on it. Okay, that's why everybody wants... Oh, there's the baseball. Aw. That's the last picture we took. There's the photo of our collection of books. And then we have all these pictures of Ned's little bunker. His nice view, his workshop. Bunker again. Oh, remember that bunker? Yeah. Apparently that was my favorite part of this whole experience, this stupid bunker. Because that's all I took pictures of. I kept forgetting about the camera. And then I'd read your all's comments saying take pictures, but I was way ahead in the game from where you guys were leaving comments, so sorry about that. What is that a picture of? Oh, that's a picture of the hole. Well, that didn't come out very well. Well, there's the tree and the ski. And I believe that's the first picture I took. The campsite, which we still don't really know what happened there. Ah, there's a picture of Henry. Remember when we very first picked up the camera, it snapped a picture of his face. Huh. So, Brian Green... whatever the heck his name was, didn't... Oh, he did take a picture. Okay, he took a picture of the dinosaur there. Well, that's pretty cool. I guess it's his dad, Ned. And there's a picture of himself. Thumbs up. And there they are together. So let me see if I have this straight. A couple years ago, Ned comes out here with his son Brian. And something happens. Either Ned kills Brian, or Brian is in an accident, a climbing accident, and he falls to his death in that cave. I don't think that Ned killed him. I think that Brian fell, and then Ned didn't really know what to do about it, so he left the body there. He just couldn't bring himself to carry the body out of there. However, that's bad. You know, now he can't, you know, time goes by. He's like, holy crap, I screwed up. I can't leave here because then people will want to know what happened to Brian. And, you know, they might think that I did it. And he certainly doesn't want anybody else to find out about it. So that's why he was trying to keep people away from the cave, right? Because he didn't want anybody to find Brian's body. So he listened in to Henry and Delilah's radio conversations. And let's see, when was it? I'm trying to think, why did he have to hit Ned? I guess because, I don't know. Why did he have to hit Ned? I mean, why did he have to hit Henry? Why did he have to hit him? I'm not real sure. Anyway, he noticed that Henry and Delilah were getting a little paranoid, and he decided to use that to his advantage. So he knew of the research station at Wapiti Meadows, and he made up all these fake reports that made it look like people were monitoring Henry and Delilah and other people. And then sent Henry in that direction. Another thing he did was after Henry went there and he heard Delilah and Henry talking about burning the place down, he recorded that message and then burned the place down, and then he had some leverage against Henry and Delilah in case, I guess, you know, they got out of there, they wouldn't say, and they found the body, they wouldn't say anything for fear that Ned would release the tape, maybe? I don't know, but turns out all along that they were not being monitored. It was just a ruse by Ned to make them paranoid and maybe for him to get some dirt on them, I guess. I don't know. Not 100% clear on it. But that's kind of what I'm getting from it right here and now. I am glad that it turned out to be that and not, you know, something supernatural or sci-fi or something, you know, ridiculous. You know, it was just some guy who was trying to protect a secret, and he went to great lengths to do it. And I'm okay with that. I think that makes for a pretty interesting story. I hope you enjoyed it too. I thank you for coming along with me on this journey. I certainly do hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for the comments you left, your encouraging comments, and for following me along here. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you join me again in another Let's Play soon.